So the one that is facing towards the front, this is known as the anterior or the ventral root. Then here, this is a ganglion. Now what you will ask, what is a ganglion? Ganglion is basically a collection of cell body which is present outside the spinal cord. And why it is called posterior root? Because it is on the back side or on the dorsal side of the spinal cord. That is why it is called as the posterior root ganglion. Then you have here that in the gray matter there is a commissure. What is a commissure? It is basically a crossing over of fibers. That the fibers that are entering from the left side, they will move towards the right side, or the fibers on the right side, they may move towards the left side. So there will be a crossing over here, and that crossing over fibers from the right to the left side or from the left to the right side is called your commissure. And as it is in the gray matter, so it is called as the gray commissure. Now, there are two nerves which are present in the peripheral nervous system, the cranial nerves and the spinal nerve. Cranial nerves will carry the impulses to the brain and from the brain to your effectors. Spinal nerves will carry impulses from your body to the spinal cord, and from the spinal cord it will carry it to the effectors. Both of them, they are present in the intervertebral foramen. It is present of the skull region. It is present in the vertebral region. There are 12 pairs of cranial nerves and there are 31 pairs of spinal nerves according to the regional vertebral column. There are 8 cervical, 12 thoracic, 5 lumbar, 5 sacral and 1 coccygeal. Now coming to this diagram, let's see. This is the gray matter of the spinal cord. It has an anterior, posterior horn and anterior horn, and you have a gray commissure which is connecting the two gray matters, and it has a central canal. The outer part of the spinal cord is known as the white matter. It consists of two roots. There is a posterior root or a dorsal root, and you have an anterior root or the ventral root. The posterior root or the dorsal root, it consists of your sensory nerves. That why they are called as sensory nerves? Because they are the nerves which are carrying impulses from our sensations like touch, pain, pressure. All of those will come through the posterior root, enter into the white matter. They will be cross-linking and they will then leave through the anterior root to the desired effector organ to perform its action. Then there will be a time that there is only one way from which the nerves will enter and nerves will leave. So as a result, the sensory and motor nerves, they will mix with one another and they will be known as the mixed nerves. And as these sensory nerves, they are carrying impulses towards the spinal cord. So the fibers of the sensory nerve or the posterior root, they are called as the afferent fibers towards the spinal cord. And the fibers of the anterior root or the ventral root, as they are carrying impulses away from the spinal cord towards the muscle, those are called as your efferent fibers. And these roots, they are united with one another by means of anterior and posterior rama. The posterior rama, its function is to conduct the impulses to the skin of your back. And the anterior rama, it conducts impulses and covers the skin of the front of the body. That was about that. Then you have the posterior root ganglion. I have told you it is a collection of the cell body present outside the spinal cord. That is why it is known as the ganglion. And it is also present in your cranial nerves. And in those cranial nerves, the ganglia that is present, those are called as your sensory ganglia. Now, there are some ganglia which are present along the autonomic nerve fibers, like in the viscera. Then there is no muscle fibers. They are either the sympathetic or parasympathetic nerve fibers going to our stomach or heart for its contraction or relaxation. In that, there is also cell bodies present because they are neurons. But the collection of those cell bodies that are present outside the autonomic nervous system, those are called as your autonomic ganglia, not your sensory or posterior root ganglia. That was all for your central nervous system, peripheral nervous system. Hope it has helped and help you understood. If you have any questions, leave behind in the comment box. Thank you.